Hello everybody, welcome back. Sorry that I'm in the car. I'm on my break and this is when I have time to do the video, so this is when we're doing it. Today we're going to be talking about home cleansing and home protection, just a little bit about home protection, how you should do it, when you should do it, and all that good stuff. We're going to be referencing Moon Magic, Your Complete Guide to Harnessing the Mystical Energy of the Moon by Diane Elquist. I think that's how you say your name. Ooh, shoot. And we're just going to kind of get right into it. So what is home cleansing? What is home protection? I've talked about this a lot on my channel. Home cleansing has to do with getting energies you do not want, old energy, stagnant energy, any of that stuff out of the home so that you can make way for the things you do want, or so that you can replace that energy with the energies you do want. Smudging is a good way to do this. Sage is a popular way to do it. Sage is not my go-to for cleansing. Part of that is because with the popularity of white sage, it is becoming so hard for Native Americans to find the sage that they have been using for centuries at a reasonable price, or they can't get it, or it's out of stock. And it's an endangered plant right now because of the popularity, white sage in specific. Green sage from your grocery store will work just as well as white sage if you want to, you know, maybe conserve on that. But also, there are so many other herbs that you're going to miss out on the qualities if you only look at sage as a way to smudge. So juniper is a good way to smudge, and juniper helps protect against thieves. Sandalwood, palo santo, they are both protective things. So yeah, I might use a little bit of sage before that, or I might use a cleansing spray and then go through with some palo santo. But if you want something that's going to cleanse before you use a protector, let's look at cedar. Cedar is good. Cedar is a good cleanser and has a great smell. It cleanses the airways just the same as sage does. It doesn't kill pathogens the way sage does in the air, but it does cleanse the airways. It does help you to breathe better and easier. And it also protects. It lays down a protection as you're smudging away the bad energy. So you're doing a two-in-one there. You're only having to go through and smudge the house one time if you're doing it with cedar. Two things I think would smell really good and I really want to try is I want to try getting a cedar bundle and smudging with that, and then smudging with a juniper bundle, because juniper smells amazing and so does cedar. So I can only imagine the good aromas that I would have in my house if I was to use those two. When should you smudge? Well, let's look at, you know, corresponding, you know, astrological correspondences. Like, for instance, I'm on page 60 of the book I just mentioned, Moon Magic, and we're looking at Friday, which is associated with Venus. Friday is ruled by Venus, the planet of love. This is the best time to focus on romance, love, friendships, dating, pleasure, partners, unions, fertility, family, etc. So this is a good day for relationships. And anytime I think of relationships, I think of love, I think of romance, any of that stuff, I'm thinking of my home life, my personal life, because that's the stuff that we wouldn't have in our work life, you know what I mean? Those are our very intimate, personal parts of our life. So that's why I would choose Friday. Saturday will give you a boost to banish something, so Saturday is a good day too. Saturday is also a known day of Sabbath, as well as Sunday. Sunday is near and dear to my heart because I'm a Southern Baptist Christian. So those are the 3 days I think are good to smudge, but you could also go Wednesday or Tuesday. Those are good days. I find I get some decent results, and that's for when I'm having a stagnant energy, a buildup of stagnant energy that's causing me to be unmotivated.
Other good times to cleanse your home would be when moving into a new home. Before you move into your home, you should go throughout the entire home and cleanse it. I would do something that cleanses away all energy, so sage is a good option to use then. But I would also do something protective, something that invites love, harmony, peace, prosperity. So you could do a mixture of like green sage, lavender, rosemary, and basil, and peppermint, and that would bring peace, love, prosperity, money, abundance, all that good stuff, all in one bundle. So I like to make my own sage bundles, and I have a video up already on that channel, on my channel, about making your own smudge bundles. But if you would like another video where I make different kinds of smudge bundles and use some of the things I mentioned today, let me know. I have a few other notable mentions. I already talked about cedar. Pine is also a good one too. Smudge with basil, rosemary, and peppermint, as I just mentioned, are very good. They can help with money, abundance, prosperity, making sure your needs are met. But basil and rosemary can help with relationships between one another. So like family relationships, love relationships, they can help in feuds. They help bring feelings of love, harmony, peace, happiness, joy, all the good things you want to feel when you're at home. I hope today's video has been helpful. I know it's kind of quick. I know I only gave you a few short blurbs of information here and there, but I hope that this has been something helpful and useful to you. I'm sorry that it's such a disaster as I'm just doing it on my break, but please leave a like, a comment, and a subscription if you haven't already, and let me know how you liked today's video. Until next time, love yourself and your world.